Plants seem like they're just sitting there, but they're actually capable of some pretty wild stuff. One particularly eye-opening example, plants can, more or less, see. Hi, I'm Kate, and this is Minute Earth. Say you add a plant to your garden. Almost immediately, plants nearby will know the new addition is there. While there are a bunch of different ways plants can communicate with each other, like via volatile chemicals in the air or fungal networks underground, when it comes to sensing potential competitors, plants seem to rely most on their visual systems. Plants obviously don't have eyes like animals do, but they do have a plantified version of the light-sensing equipment in animals' eyes. Proteins called photoreceptors, which are triggered by certain wavelengths of light, basically different colors. And to a plant, one of the most important colors is what's called far red. This is light at the most extreme red end of the spectrum, past what we humans can see best. See, it just so happens that green vegetation reflects a lot of far red light compared to other colors, especially compared to how much normal red they reflect. That's not the case with most other objects out in the world. So if a plant's photoreceptors start registering a relatively high amount of far red light coming from a certain direction, there's almost certainly some leafy stuff growing there. Leafy stuff that will eventually start encroaching on the plant's life-giving sunlight, as well as creating competition for lots of other resources. In other words, photoreceptors allow a plant to see a future competitor before they're actually a problem. With this advance notice, the plant has a chance to get a leaf up on the competition. Plants are rooted in place, so they can't exactly just up and move. But they do have other options, like growing faster or sprouting new leaves, especially on the side opposite the competitor, to gobble up additional light, even flowering early to try to get a reproductive edge. And even though we don't generally think of plants as quick, these kinds of responses can start as soon as a few minutes after a plant registers a change in far red light. Maybe you could argue that an organism needs eyes to see. But what plants are doing, using specialized biological equipment to gather information about different wavelengths of light and using that information to change how they're interacting with their surroundings, is remarkably similar to what animals do with their eyes. I don't know about you, but I am seeing plants in a whole new light. What's more, it turns out that the information conveyed by different wavelengths of light isn't just important for plants. It's also important for humans studying plants. That's because if light quality affects how plants interact with their neighbors, light quality likely has really important ramifications for how ecosystems function. One group studying the role of light quality in ecosystem diversity and productivity is the ASCEND Project, a National Science Foundation-funded biological integration institute led by Janine Cavender-Bears, Phil Townsend, and Peter Reich. The ASCEND team harnesses observations, state-of-the-art experiments, and theory to better understand the causes and consequences of changes in plant biodiversity in a rapidly changing world. In addition to advancing knowledge, ASCEND is training the next generation of integrative biologists to better see how life's variation is connected across scales and impacted by global change.